Alright, that time of the week again. Return to play news. Seem to be doing this video like every 5 days, like the update on returning to play. Wearing the Vancouver skate jersey because I hope we get skating soon. See what I did there? Unfortunately, the London, Ontario labour negotiations don't exist as a hockey team, so we're going to have to deal with my terrible puns. But yeah, let's dive in. So for those of you who don't know, obviously still January 1 is still the circle date, even though I think we're like less than 40 days away now. I think it's like 39 from hitting that date. So we're getting really close to that not really being an eventuality. I think if we kind of get to Wednesday, Thursday this week and there's no deal broken, I can't see it possible for them to hit that date. I've always said it'll be somewhere between Jan 15 because I don't think the players are going to want to give up Christmas with the training camps. Obviously, some teams, the teams that weren't in the playoffs get 3 weeks of training camp. So I wouldn't even be surprised if it's around that 15th mark just so they can get started about the 27th and then, go for a few extra days. Might even be a little bit after that. Up to Feb 1, I think that's somewhere in that. You've got the Summer Olympics, so that's the only thing that they're not going to really want to be playing games during that. So yeah, lots to break down. So right now we're kind of in a stalemate with money, but not in a bad way. Not in the sense that it's like both teams are like, oh, we're going to be money hungry, grubbing, and that would be a terrible narrative to have right now. And obviously, especially with everyone going on, with a lot of people out of work and whatnot, bit of a sour taste to leave in people's mouths. But it just looks like they're trying to figure out how they're going to do this. Raising escrow is not going to happen, but it looks like it's going to be deferral payments. And then, so obviously, the PA said no originally to that. I think it's more because there weren't any guarantees involved, or that they need to have something in place, because the NHL, especially if you go through past labour negotiations, you can't exactly take them on their word, so they might need legislation into the CBA to get that to move. And then obviously you can get things going. It looks like they want to save about $390 million next season, so that's quite a chunk of change that they've got to take off the books. So you look at some of the places now and the way COVID's taken off, it's unreal. Like the thoughts of getting people into arenas safely, I can't see that happening at all. If you're in America, I'm sorry if that you don't want to hear that, but I think in every single state, 1 in 10 people in hospital right now are there because of COVID. And in some places, it's 20%, you know, 2 in 10, so 1 in 5. It's crazy, and you're about to see a pretty big wave of deaths come through. And it's really sad, really sad. What's happening there? I mean, some places in Texas that are 50% hospital right now, and you just sort of see the stats of the cases and the people on ventilators and the people in intensive care, and it's very reminiscent of the start of the year when that death toll kind of ballooned up. I think you're going to see something very similar there, which is very sad, and I think hopefully it'll start to hit home to some people that you can't go out anymore and can't do these things. But yeah, Thanksgiving's just around the corner, or I think it's this weekend. We don't have it in Australia, so yeah, and then you've got Christmas. So yeah, I can't imagine that fans are going to arenas. I just can't. I can't see it. I could be wrong. I think it's wrong if they are, but yeah, until there's a vaccine or things die down, I can't see it happening, but I guess we'll see. So I don't think the owners can bank on money being in that hip pocket and fans going to arenas. I just don't think you can even say 20%, and you just can't. So I think trying to work out a deal to save some money, or at least defer the payments down the road, as long as they're guaranteed, I think that's fair and reasonable for both sides. I think it's just working out how that will work. Division realignment, looks like we're getting some division realignment. Some teams, the way it's going to be has been announced. I'll link down below to a Wyszynski article that went through all of that. But yeah, that's exciting. The Penguins are in for a real treat. Gonna play Detroit. I mean, that's the best. It's interesting. The Pacific also, like, yeah, they're versing all those like California teams. That's gonna be handy. But yeah, it's super interesting how that's all gonna work out, and then try to figure out what the playoff format is. I think it must be 1 to 16 because you can't do divisions, although they might try it, but I just don't think they should this year. Especially with, like, you just know that some team's not going to be able to play all the games. You just know that stuff like that's going to happen. So they definitely want a bit of leeway at the end of the season to try at least marry that up as much as they can. So I guess we'll see how it's all going to work. Anyway, guys, that's the full update. I think we'll get some pretty big news this week. I think we'll, if we don't get a date this week, I think we'll have, by the end of it, some pretty positive talks that it's like, righto, it's happening. They've got to change a fair bit with what's going on right now. So I get it. You got to make sure everything's all fine and cross the T's and dot the I's and be ready to pivot at any time, just because that's what I do. Yeah, I'm really worried by the amount of people that are like, oh, 2020 is almost over, thank God, look at 2021. Start of 2021 ain't going to be any better. Like, sorry to burst your bubble, but yeah, you might as well strap yourself in and get ready. I think the end of 2021 would be great, be able to go outside again. But, like, not that we can't do that in Australia at the moment, because everything's pretty under control, but I think we're starting to get back to some normality in life. But yeah, well, I guess we'll see how it all works out. Anyway, guys, that is the whole video. If you did like this video, hit the like button. Otherwise, hit subscribe down below. That really does help us out. We're over 300 now, so that's exciting. Another video coming out where we're running through every single one of the first round draft picks that were picked in 2020 to see how they've started their seasons, if they're allowed to play, what their injury status are, just pretty much everything. So you guys can sort of get a nice little update, because I feel like no one really follows up on these people. And then we see them in the league in 3 years and we're like, oh yeah, that was that guy that was picked like 20th. So I think we might, every now and then, check in. I think I might do it for the last few years, for the next few weeks, just do a video on, check in on them, see how the little kitty's doing. But yeah, anyway, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. See you, and bye.